I wanted to update you guys on how everything's been going and how everything went. So we got here on September 28th. Oh, and we live in New York. Yeah, we are stationed in New York, our first PCS. Oh yeah. Anyway, it's actually supposed to snow tomorrow through the Friday.
Bitch, what?
Through Friday, and I work Thursday, so I'm kind of like freaking out, but because I'm all alone. But anyway, so right now it's just me and Darren because my husband isn't here. He's in the field. Like, why? Whatever. Yeah, he's in the field right now. I actually work now. I'm working. I work on post. And so basically, we got here the 28th. And before that, I made sure to contact, well, if you want to live on post, I made sure to contact the community center, like the people who do the housing. And I did that, and thankfully everything went smoothly, thank God. I don't know how it is with other forts, but here in Fort Drum, it went really smoothly. We just paid like a pro rate, and from our BH, and then we got to move in. Like, guys, I just wanted to add on a little side note that if you want your stuff to arrive as soon as possible, you better run to that transportation office, because things take forever. The army always takes forever to do things. So if you want it to be fast, either do it before, try to do it before, or once you get here, like to your station, do it right away. Tell your man to go to transportation and do all that, because it takes forever. It took us 2 months to get everything. Two. Like, we did a remote assistance, remote move-in assistance thing, program thing that they have. And I did all this while my husband was in AIT. Because if not, then, you know, he would probably still be living in the barracks, or I'd be like waiting for like another apartment or whatever. And it would have just taken too long. So I went ahead and did that as soon as possible. As soon as I found out where he was getting stationed, that's what I recommend. If you don't want to live on post, you can always go to ahrn.com, and there's another one that's for off post housing. You can go ahead and search that, and you will see everything that's off post within your like BAH, and then some like above. But I went ahead and searched that up, because at first we were going to live off post, because we didn't want to live on post, because my husband kept saying like, oh, I don't want to, you know, get off of work and then go home and still be like surrounded by like the military. But I always want to live on post, because I already knew that everything was included first. Second, the safety of us, like for times like this where I'm alone with the baby. And third, the convenience. That's what I always heard, that it was very convenient, mostly for the service member, because it was right there, like from your job. Literally, Aaron's job, his company is like 5 minutes away, compared to if you live off post and you have to come into the base, you have to wait like, I don't know how long, because I've never done it, but like, I've gone out when everybody's getting off of work, and it's like a humongous traffic line, so I can't imagine when you're trying to get in the morning. But yeah, his job is like right there, my job is right there, so very convenient. And then it's very like safe here too. I mean, you still have like, you know, you still have to be careful, but it's more safe than outside, because, you know, military police are always like driving around. When you enter the post, you have to
you know, show your ID and all that, make sure that you're like a military like spouse or a military dependent or, you know, military personnel. So everything's like pretty safe or whatever. Nobody really bothers us here. I haven't really had too many issues. My next door neighbor's pretty cool, and the one downstairs is pretty cool too. Like I haven't really had any issues. But yeah, I recommend that if you want to everything to go smoothly and fast, I recommend to do that while your spouse is in AIT. So then everything could happen smoothly and then you'll be with them. And now I'm just, you know, waiting till he gets back home. Thankfully, I get the holidays with him and then he goes back out. After January, I'm a little, not concerned, but I'm just, you know, a little worried just because I don't know what's gonna happen. I really don't want to deal with a deployment, but if I do, I will record that. I will do a lot of updates. But yeah, that's basically everything. I got my braces off, if you guys didn't notice. Yeah, I'm finally going to the city too. There's not really much to do up here in Fort Drum, the area. Except for like Syracuse, and that's like an hour and a half away. But yeah, so that's pretty much it. Yeah, I'll check you guys later. Oh my god, guys, it's like so windy outside. Oh, it's raining. It legit sounds like a hurricane. Look at that. Well, you can't look at it, but I think you can hear it. Oh my god. And it's supposed to snow tonight? That is so scary. Oh my gosh. I'm all alone. Right now. Where's Aaron? Aaron! Look, this little dude knocked out. Without a shoe, of course. Like always.